Hello and welcome back to another episode of Sims 4 Cottage Living, where we're still in Tartosa, getting ready for Ian and Derek's vow renewal. I'm so excited. Pretty sure this is our last day that I booked here. I booked 3 days, so we might have to extend our vacation, because I am not done with this place. I thought I'd be done by now exploring, but we've barely gone anywhere. And it's also Love Day today, and I did say last episode that we might get married, nope, we might do the vow renewal on Love Day, but I know we will not have time for it. Why is there a random child in my room? Hi, can you go away? Why is there a kid in my house? Go away, please. Leave. Go. Yeah, go away. Thank you. What? No. Who says you can just be here? Okay, this is weird. I don't like that. Ignoring that, Ian here made some French toast for everybody this morning, which is quite nice of him, although it seems to be poor quality. I don't know why, he's level 10. Oh, I'm sorry, Wolfgang, we can't come over. We're in a whole nother town, city, country, wherever we are. We're in a whole nother different one. Okay, and I'm pretty sure I got Flynn to pour some calming tea, so we can pour that for everybody and have our tea in the morning as well. I do like this little routine we've got going on, having breakfast and tea. It's very British. And I don't know why a tea set didn't come with the Cottage Living expansion pack when that was supposed to be based on the British countryside, but whatever, it's fine. Okay, let's all grab cups of teas, because tasty. Why are they different? Okay, no, it was just the lighting. I thought they were different colours then. See, that looks like a prettier colour than that. Oh well. Okay, why is everybody unhappy? From being an introvert that's scanning... Oh, I've just updated Slice of Life, so they're all figuring out their personalities again. Okay. Terrible... Yeah, well, you're the one who made the poorly made food, so... It's not my fault. Yeah, a new update came to add more story progression into the game, and it broke like all my mods in between recordings, so yeah, I had to update everything. I say everything. So far it's just UI cheats and Slice of Life, so I've updated them, so we should be good. We're all good. Don't worry about it. Okay, right. What is the goal for today? Apparently it's sitting away from the rest of your family. That is the goal here with Ian. Don't know what's up with him. Maybe it's just because there are only two bar stools here. How sad. Okay, alright, let's get this family not so stinky. And just, oh my gosh, and just ready for the day. And hopefully we'll be leaving soon. Okay, you guys have your own personal thing here. You're not that smelly, but you may as well take a shower like everybody else. Get them all nice and cleaned up and we can head out on the town. Okay, hang on a sec. I just have to show you this. He's brought his cup of tea in the bath with him. That is all. Okay, we've made it to the plaza and there's this little flower stall here that I saw last episode but we never actually interacted with. So I've sent Ian here to come buy flowers, but apparently that just means one singular flower. But since it's Love Day, I guess we can buy a flower, and Derek's favourite colour is yellow, so we're gonna get him a chrysanthemum, because that's really cute to give him his favourite coloured flower. And he's here talking to Flynn, but we're gonna be like, I'm gonna give you a Love Day gift. We apparently already had 12 chrysanthemums almost, but it's more romantic to go buy it fresh, right? Except from the things that have been in inventory for ages. And oh my gosh. Yay, it really matches his... Maybe there are chrysanthemums on his top. What's on Flynn's top then? I have no clue. Shirt. It's more of a shirt than a top. Okay, so we got that tradition done. I don't remember what Ian's favourite colour is. Do you have a favourite colour? You apparently do. Oh, I didn't mean to click that. Okay, it seems like it's a bit awkward. Ian's favourite colour is orange, and he dislikes... what the hell? And he dislikes yellow, which is kind of sad, because that's his favourite colour, but You know, whatever, it's fine. What's your favorite color? You have a lot of likes. You like brown and green, do you? Well, you've got some brown pants on, so... trousers on, so I suppose that works. Oh yeah, I forgot I got a mod that adds this stuff too. That's fun. Okay. Anyway, events today. Well, you two need to be romantic and go on these dates and things, and... I'm sorry, Flynn, but unless you can invite Wolfgang out here, I don't know. I don't know what you're gonna be doing today. Is he just able to? Maybe he's rich and he's just able to fly over to Tartosa for the day, so these guys can go on some dates. That'll be fun. Yeah, he'll be right over. Okay, cool. And he is getting embarrassed by his parents flirting, so you know what? We'll move him over here to wait for Wolfgang, and these two. We're gonna go flirtstin' and datestin' and having a great old time. I love it. Okay, so where are we gonna go on a date to? That's the thing. I don't actually know. There aren't really any places here. I guess we could just walk around. I wanted to see what this stall was that Flynn was at the end of last episode. It's just a food stall again. Are they particularly hungry? No, we're not going to a festival. Go away! Go away! Thank you. Are they particularly hungry? No, they're not. Okay, they're really not in the mood to do anything. I'm gonna go place down a lot, because there aren't any other lots to visit. And I want to do something kind of related to prepping for their vow renewal. So I'll go find a lot to do with that. And we can go on a date there. Okay, so I've placed down a hair salon from the gallery. It's just the first one that comes up when you type in hair salon and go for the most popular. But I have changed it a little bit to fit in Tartosa a bit more than it did. Because the skill scheme and the style wasn't exactly fitting. But, you know, I'm not a builder, so I just kind of changed all the swatches from black to brown. Really, that's kind of it. This is a sim... that I've had to add to the household to make this mod I got work, because it's supposed to be for you to be the hairdresser and not for you to be the client, so yeah, I've had to add her to our family just so she can be our hairdresser and give us a style makeover thingamajigger. So yeah, here's the inside. It's very good. The person who made it is quite talented, and all I've really done is added this, this little area right here. Just because it looked the aesthetic. I don't know. Don't look at it too hard. It's messy. But what I'm gonna do is I'm going to offer Ian a makeover, and then we can take him into Cass. And I don't know. It gives it a bit more of a realistic feel to come to an actual hair salon and be seated and get some professional help. That makes it sound like it's a mental condition getting your hair done. But yeah, these guys, I don't know if I'm actually going to change their hairstyles at all or if I'm just going to pretend they're here for a trim. I guess it depends. Wait, are you going to give him the hairstyle or what? Can you shape up my eyebrows? You really want your eyebrows changing? Can I have my hair like yours? No, you cannot. Why will she not? Why will she not give the, give I thought I play tested this like 2 seconds ago. Why is he angry at us? I play tested this like 2 seconds ago and it worked just fine. Hang on, maybe they need to be friends. Will you guys do it now, please? Yes. Hey, okay, apparently they have to be friends, which I don't understand why you have to be friends to get your hair done, since this is supposed to be a mod that lets you just taking clients, but you know what? Apparently we're also getting our makeup done. But you know what? It's fine. Don't worry about it. We're gonna get some makeup as well. That seems fun. I like it. Okay, sure, I agree. Let's get some makeup done. And I'm gonna take these guys into Cass and give them a bit of a makeover, I suppose. Okay, so hair and makeup is done, and I'm not going to show you either of those things until the day, I think. Okay, so hair and makeup is done, but I'm not going to show you either of those things until the day, the event itself. I'm going to keep you guys in the dark as to what's going on. All I'm going to tell you is that everybody looks adorable. I absolutely cannot wait, but now we've got hair and makeup done, we need to design these outfits for these boyos. they've got to wear something nice and formal for the event, so I'm going to go find a clothing store. There's got to be something more fancy. What is the male version of a wedding dress shop? A suit shop? I guess a tailor's. Aha! I figured it out. We're gonna go and find a tailor's. Okay, so after ages of building my own tailor shop because I couldn't find one in the gallery, it's now like 2 a.m. in the morning, 1 a.m. and poor Flynn. I've been trying desperately to get Wolfgang to come over in between takes and things, but he either is asleep. Like, your dad just made you... Okay, well... He's either asleep or busy and won't respond or whatever, so it's fine. Or he does come over, like when I invited him to come over when we were down there, but then I immediately left. So, yeah, that was... oops. So, Flynn's gonna have a terrible day. He's gonna end the holiday being really sad, not completing any traditions. And I'm sorry about that, Flynn, but I really did try. At least your parents had a good time. Why? No, don't make any more, for God's truth's sake. Okay, I don't know why he's just gone and placed that here. Can we at least move it inside? Hello, hairdresser lady. Can you leave? MCCC has, MCCC, yeah, has finished work, has not finished work, is broken. So I can't just use that to make her go away now, and there's no go away button either, so I guess she's just here. Because how are you supposed to tell Sims to leave? Send home from vacation. She was added to my vacation? Yeah, go away. Okay, cool. That works. Yeah, go away. Okay. I didn't know that was what was wrong. I guess adding her to the household also added her to the vacation. Oh my gosh, I am having a terrible time. And yeah, oh Flynn. No, I'm sorry, buddy. I didn't mean for you to have such a terrible holiday. It just kind of worked out that way. Right, let's get these guys to eat some more of this stuff since they spent forever making it. I don't want it to go off. Well, it won't because I'll put it in the fridge, but eat it, please. Thank you. Alright, you put the leftovers away. And I guess I'll see you guys in the morning. Well, I guess it's morning already. Oh, sorry, Derek. I'll see you guys in the morning when everybody's had at least a few hours of sleep. Good morning, find friendly people. It's 10 a.m. in the morning now. Way later than any of these people are used to getting up. But I guess I had a late night last night. And good old Ian has woken up with his bladder completely empty. Well, not completely empty, but very low. And I feel like it's part... Well, I guess it is part of his old age. He's starting to feel the effects of being so old now. And it worries me, because these men need to last long enough to have a vow renewal. Maybe see Flynn get himself married? Probably not, though. Oh, that makes me so sad to think about. Okay, well, I guess the rest of the household can wake up now and also get some leftovers from last night. So that's gonna be tasty. You guys wanna wake up too? Yeah, everyone else seems perfectly fine for toilet needs, including Derek. He doesn't seem to have any trouble with it. I don't know why. It's just Ian. It's kind of sad. Okay, we're gonna have breakfast. We're going to get some tea. Oh, okay. Ian's already making some tea. That's perfectly fine by me. What was it? What is it? What tea did you make? What did he clean it? Okay, well, I guess I have to pour the tea to find out. And why are you wearing that? No. Why your correct outfit? I didn't make it just for you to not wear it. And you need to get dressed. And is this poor quality again? I don't know what Ian's problem is, but every time he makes something, it is just terrible quality. He's supposed to be level 10. I don't get it. Okay, you put your outfit back on, please. I miss having MCC. Why is there a strange... Why are there two strangers in my house? You two aren't even from this pack. You're both very orange. Can you, like, not be here? No. What is with these mother and daughter duos coming in and invading my house? Honestly. Like, Last time when there was that kid in my house, there was also its mum here too, and I don't know why they keep doing this to me. Don't make food. Don't make food. We got food in the fridge. I keep telling these people so many times, don't make food. We've got food in the fridge. Why are you canceling on me? Stop canceling me. I didn't do nothing wrong. Yeah, thank you. I really don't know why this random lady's in my house. It makes me quite uncomfortable. And even more so that I can't just send her away. Oh, do you remember what my zodiac sign is? I don't know what month you were born, but yes. Yes, I remember your zodiac sign. Of course I do. Yeah, we can answer that kind of message. So he's not mad at us. Or maybe that's a message saying he is mad at us. I don't know. Men are confusing. But, wow, isn't this just a lovely time? It's the family and the random lady. The random orange lady. Okay. How about we go from this side? And now we have no idea she's there. Did you just spill your tea on the floor? Okay, well... Gosh darn it. Okay, well, I'm gonna get these guys' needs all sorted out as normal, and I'll see you guys at the tailors. Okay, we're back at the hair salon that I robbed from the gallery, which, by the way, I'll put the name of the person who made this lot down in the description, but yes, we're back here, and apparently Derek wants another trim. And we've actually got another building right here that I built to kind of be a cafe and a tailor's, a wedding dress shop. I kind of just made it myself because I couldn't find anything good enough on the gallery. Well, not like there wasn't anything good enough, it's just there was nothing with the name Tailors on, so I just made one myself. So yes, that's what we're gonna do if Derek would like to leave. Okay. Oh, also I'll put the mod that I used, or at least a link to the website that the mod came from, in the description. So you guys can get it too if that was any kind of interesting to you. But oh my gosh, I'm fiddling with these buttons and not getting anything right. So we have the cafe this side and the tailors this side. And I don't know, I just kind of made the front look fun, I guess. It's fun, I like it. We gotta go inside and we got a bunch of stuff. We got a little fitting room and a toilet and the lady that I always think is Afmal, but obviously isn't. If you don't know who Afmal is, it's just another YouTuber that I used to watch when I was like 10. Anyway, no, go away, Santa, not the time. Let's go inside here and hopefully somebody starts manning the cash register. Or are we gonna have to go all the way over here? No, nobody's on this one either. It's a retail lot, so I thought it would function like one, but I guess not. This is the only half of the mannequin stands, I guess, we're going to worry about. It's these side with... not quite what I was going for. It's the side with all the male's clothing, or the male frame clothing, I think is what you're supposed to say. It's got mostly my wedding stories stuff, and then like a few base game, I think. Same here. Actually, no, I think these are all my wedding stories. They're very pretty. There were so many dresses, I couldn't choose any of them? No, I couldn't choose all of them, so I had to just go with a few, but I like them, they're fun, and these two seem to really enjoy their time here. Oh, maybe they're flirting, maybe they're singing, it's hard to tell. And there are a lot of people here, oh my gosh. Okay, what do we need? I put a bunch of stuff on these shelves, thinking that we might want to buy something, like, what's this? The purchase books? Oh, okay, it's a book purchasing area. Well, I'm assuming that must have been a romance book. And maybe we can buy one? Do we want to buy a romance book, Flynn? sure. We'll buy Untamed Treachery of the Heart. I had to choose the one that I couldn't pronounce in there. Okay, so we've brought that. That's good. These guys are gonna be looking at these outfits, thinking about which ones we want to get. Dance with Mannequin? I've never actually played with retail stores before, so I didn't know you could do this. What does that look like? It can't look like anything proper, right? Yeah, he's just jigging. He's just doing a wiggle next to it. I actually thought he might grab it and start, like, slow dancing with it, but oh well. Oh, someone's flirty? Derek's flirty! Oh, from being serenaded. Oh my gosh, is that what he was doing? I didn't know they were he was serenading them. Oh, dancing is terrible. Ah, okay. He danced with a mannequin. He's now decided it's terrible. All right, fair enough. Let's go get you guys into the fitting room, or at least maybe one by one we'll get you into the fitting room. I think Derek's chosen his outfit, so we'll send him in here first and get his outfit fitted. And yet again, I'm not going to show you what it looks like until the actual event. Well, maybe I'll show you a sneak peek, depending on how generous I feel. Are you still dancing with the mannequin? You just said you hated it, so get in there. Go, in the changing room, now. Go, speed. Vamanos. Thank you. Apparently he's Spanish. Is that Spanish? I don't know. Oh, hey, Derek. Good job, we are partners. Okay, yeah, I'll see you guys once these guys have done their makeovers. Okay, well, everybody's outfits have been designed and organized and... Flynn looks really happy with himself. I wonder if he really likes his outfit. Or he's trying to tell me by looking directly at me that he wants a- He's looking right at me! That he wants a few of these items on here. And I'm guessing since he's standing right in front of these, he might want one of these makeup palettes, which I am awful for getting. They're only like 3 simoleons, so we'll be fine. And I guess... like this cream? This shampoo, maybe? I don't know, why not? He seems to be getting some influence from... Yay, he's all happy now. He seems to be getting influence from Wolfgang to try out some more makeup on himself, which I am all for. It's gonna be so much fun putting him in makeup. And I guess we're done here now. Flynn and Derek has spent his whole time in the bathroom, but they've all got on their outfits now, so... Oh, it's as if... We're and I guess it is, actually, that we are encroaching on the date. The event, it's gonna be happening soon, but how much more things do we have to prepare? Apart from, you know, all the preparations that came with the pack that I haven't even touched yet. Yeah, I suppose we should go cake testing next. Cake tasting next. But I'm not entirely sure where you do that, so I guess I gotta find that first. Good news? Found the cake stand. Bad news, it closes at 6. But second good news is Wolfgang's here. He just kind of appeared. I guess these constant invites I've been sending him and all the messages he's been sending us has convinced him to come over and hang out, which I am excited about. I guess he really did have a lot of money and just decided to fly on over here for the evening, as sad as that is. I really wanted to be able to do some cake testing, but yes, we're going to be doing experiments on the cake. No, I wanted to do some cake tasting, but everywhere's closed now, so that's kind of a bummer, but oh well, I guess these old farts are gonna head home, go to sleep early today, and then hopefully we'll be up bright and early at 9 a.m. to come and do some cake tasting tomorrow. But that'll be in the next episode. Since Wolfgang has finally made an appearance, I wanted to spend some time with him. I feel bad not getting to spend any time with him on Love Day, so we're doing it now. It's happening. It's gonna happen. He's probably here, like, judging the outfit. And probably, oh no, maybe not, but judging his outfit here and how strange and different it is to his normal farm boy clothes. And these guys are going through a whole whale of emotions right here, but let's just, I don't even know where we'd go. Isn't there a beach? This is a beach lot, but apparently there's absolutely enough. There's more to do on this beach that's not a lot than the beach that is a lot. I guess it's supposed to be empty, but you know what? Whatever. It's fine. We're gonna go here, since we don't have to go through a thingamajiggy here. I guess we're just gonna hang out and spend the night with each other. Or maybe Wolfgang's got a better idea and we head to the bar that he knows is in the area, because of course he knows there's a bar in the area. Of course he does. But right now, I kind of want to do something kind of cute. No? Too uncomfortable to do this? Ugh. Slice of Life is really messing with me today. I don't know why they keep having this scanning the area and all these things from the new update of Slice of Life, but it's bugging me. It makes them always unable to do anything. But I don't like that. Draw heart in the sand together? I didn't know they could do this together. Okay. Okay, we're doing that now. Confirmed. Guys? Guys, draw a heart in the sand. Guys? Guys? Oh. Kind of thought they'd both at least do the wiggling around animation in the sand. But no. Just on their own. Oh well, it put Flynn in a flirty mood. Ooh, he's got a little buff for it. He did have one for the smiley face, but I never read it. Sandy sentimentality. The romantic sands have inspired Flynn to create art. Art, he says. Okay, well how about we create art in a different way? too forward? Yeah, too forward. He's feeling awkward. Okay, I've heard about this lover's tree that I really want to find. I don't know where it's supposed to be, but we've not gone around much. Like, I didn't even know this fountain was here. So that says something. I want to go find this lover's tree wherever it might be. Oh, that rhymed. That's fun. But I don't see where it could be. That also rhymed. Oh no, we're on an endless loop of rhymes. But it can't be that far away because, like, this area is not travelable. That house is glowing. She's got some great skincare routines going on. Yeah, not seeing where this tree is meant to be. It's supposed to be, like, really obvious, right? I guess not. Maybe we have to travel somewhere else to find it. But, I guess since we can't find that tree, we'll go over to this fountain here and spend some time over here together. That'll be fun. How about we go sit on this bench and do some flirts? Okay, so it seems like the boys have found a quiet spot next to this fountain to just, oh, be cute. These two never seem to actually get to just be together and flirty and cute together, and that is so sweet. Look at him. Oh, these boys. You should really take that hat off. You are kind of whacking him in the face with your hat there. Maybe take that off real quick. It's kind of awkward and ruins the mood, but this is the only way I can do it since I don't have MCC anymore. Wait, get no, don't, please don't leave. Please don't leave. Sit back down. Please. Please, continue the cuteness. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Don't pull out your phone. No, don't pull out your phone. Be wholesome little babies. Oh my gosh. I wish someone would look at me the way Wolfgang looks at Flynn. Oh my gosh. Look at that. It's so sweet. Come on, tickle him. Betty's ticklish. I love it. Well, that's all I've got time for in today's episode. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye. Oh, yes.
Galnim Savanya. Cyber blooming. Cyber blooming. Oh, die.